Shalom, shalom. It is Wednesday, September 22nd. And if you've been watching any of my videos, then I've been talking a lot about my lemon curd recipe that, that I've created last week? Yes. It is wonderful, you guys. You've got to try it because it is wonderful. It is a canning recipe, so it's going to make quite a bit. It's, the recipe will make 9 of the half pints. And what got me interested in the lemon curd was I remember, I have so many memories like years ago of enjoying some lemon curd and the lemon pies that my mom used to make. And so fried lemon pies. So there are healthier ways to cook it. We're vegan now, so the ingredients that are typically used in lemon curd is are things that we don't eat anymore. As great as a pie filling, you can use it in lemon bars on toast, etc. So it's typically really easy to make. It doesn't take a long time to make it. Even this recipe, canning, it doesn't take long at all. We don't eat animal products anymore. So that's a problem when you come to lemon curd, because it uses butter, it uses cream, it uses eggs. So when I was creating the recipe, and I'm probably just going to read this off of my website. By the way, head over to my website and download this recipe. It will look a little different because it will actually have a picture. I don't have a picture of there just yet. So I will link it below this video, and I will put the link below this picture for this recipe. And so it will be print out really nice, and you can use it for future references. I looked on the internet, and I looked and I looked and I looked and I looked, and there's a couple recipes, just a couple recipes for like single serving lemon curd. And there was an issue with some of the starches that they had, that they used, or just various things that those recipes didn't work for me or for our family. So so I had to start problem solving. And one of the things that I needed to problem solve was the egg yolks. Egg yolks are used to, for one thing, to saponify. Saponification is the incorporation of an acid, a fat, and protein. And it happens when you make mayonnaise. It happens when you make soap. It combines everything into this nice thick consistency. And so that's one thing that the egg yolk provides, but it also provides the color. So I had to problem solve for the color, just a very typical turmeric powder for the color, that's very typically used, very widely used in whole food cooking to replace the yellow color. For the egg yolks, you're talking about, they add some fat, they add some protein, and there's a lot of the thickeners that are used that just impart a bitter, kind of chalky taste, and I don't like that. So I'm very careful about which thickeners I use. I'm using arrowroot powder. Okay, let's try that again. So I'm using arrowroot powder. By the way, if you want to make labels like this, it's those are name tags, Avery name tags. So so arrowroot powder is a really nice, and it doesn't lend a taste or a chalky consistency. So I love using that for thickening things in the kitchen. And it also kind of helps give it a creamy texture as well. And you can find it in most box stores like Walmart, Kroger, Food Lion. They all carry it. Earth Air obviously has it. Health food stores should have it. Azure Standard carries it. So there's a lot of places that carry that. And I already covered the color. Now you could, if you use too much turmeric, it's going to make it spicy and it's not going to taste good. It just takes a little. So that takes care of the color. Don't use too much of the turmeric because it will be too spicy and it will alter the flavor. But just a little bit lends the color. You could leave it out if you don't want to, but your lemon curd is going to have like a whitish color from the arrowroot. And I recommend using freshly squeezed lemons. The fresh squeezed lemons add that je ne sais quoi that is, that's lemon curd. I mean, that's just, you know, it's never as good if it's been bottled as it is when it's fresh for citrus juices. And we also add sugar because that will also help with the thickening process and it adds sweetness. So the coconut milk, read your ingredients, y'all. Read your ingredients. It should just say coconut milk and water. Don't use anything that has extra thickeners in it because it's gonna not turn out right. I use the Golden Star brand. I love these. Consistently the same every time. So I love it. And you're going to use the whole can. You're not going to separate the water and use just the cream. You're going to use the whole can, the cream and the water. It's super simple. It's kind of like a dump and cook and then bottles. It's very simple, very easy to do. And the last ingredient is salt. Now you have the trifecta of the fat, the sweet, and the salt. And that is, that's the trifecta flavor profile that, is so addicting. Let me grab that lemon that just escaped and we will get to cooking. Let me just add, you can use, it also calls for lemon zest, which I actually really love because I kind of actually like the texture of that, but I'm not going to use the zest in this recipe because these are, not organic lemons. And I suggest they're usually heavily sprayed. I suggest not using the zest of ones that are not lemon. So not organic. I'm gonna adjust the camera and then we'll get started recording so you can see what I'm doing. All right, so the first thing we need to do is we need 3 cups of lemon juice. Okay, got a little sidetracked. My mother-in-law called and asked me to get her some sweatshirts because she's cold in the therapy room. So I'll go and do that so I didn't forget. Then I got some lemons. Okay, so I've got my water bath can pot going with hot water. So it is ready to go. And see, that's why I have this filter on here, because I just spilt seeds everywhere. I'm just cleaning these floors this morning too. We're not going to need this many, so I don't know, we might. Let's see. This is probably going to take longer than anything else, is juicing the lemons. Okay, that is 3 1/3 cups of juice, but that's okay. I can deal with the third. I don't think it has to be that exact, but I guess we'll find out, won't we? All right, so next ingredient is 4 cups of sugar. Okay. This is a 1 cup measuring cup, so as long as it's full. Two. Three. And four. Next is 1 1/3 cup of arrowroot powder. All right, I'm going to mix this sugar in because I'm also going to have to mix this in a little bit so it's not all massively clumpy. Woo! Okay. There's a third. There's a cup. I'm not worried about scraping it off or being 100% exact because who has time for that? Quarter teaspoon of salt. Quarter teaspoon of turmeric. You would also add your lemon zest in here if you've got it. Let me stir that starch around so it's not a giant clump like that right there. Ah, that's better. Okay, so 1 1/4 teaspoons of turmeric. Apparently, I wasn't good at remembering when I was writing down the instructions this morning. Sorry about that. I also did not measure the turmeric last time, so I was guessing, and apparently I guessed wrong. So, basically, you just want it to have a nice yellow color. And now I'm going to dump in the coconut milk. This brand of coconut milk is also really wonderful if you want to separate the water. Just pop it in the fridge. Don't shake it up. Just pop it in the fridge overnight and it will separate and you'll have the nice cream at the top and the water at the bottom. Now this actually has some oil that rose to the top and that's okay. Now if I were doing it with anything else, I would have drained that off. Like if my coffee or something, I would have drained that oil off. So now we're going to mix this in and we're going to turn the stove on medium. I've got it like between 5 1/2. And it's mostly the starch, that the arrowroot, that is the thickening it up. The sugar is playing a role, but it's mostly the arrowroot. Look, there we go. Almost ready. I wanted to, oh, there we go. If you could see that, when I lift it up, I wanted to leave like a little bit of a trail right there. All right, do you see how it's leaving a trail like that? It's going to thicken up some more, which is fine. That's what we want. But yeah, this is ready to jar. I just needed to get it off of the eye. I wish I could get Todd on here to make some stuff because he is such a good cook. All right, we are ready to... Look at that. How beautiful. See how it's clinging? That is beautiful. And that is exactly what we want. So now I need my spoon from yesterday. So, if you're like us, we buy a lot of lemons, and sometimes we don't use as many as we anticipate during the week. So, this is a really good way to preserve it, which is what actually got me to do this, because I was like, well, how in the world can I save these lemons and not let them go to waste? Definitely, as careful as I was in trying to not get any on the edge of the rim, I still did. So you really need to make sure you're wiping your lids off. Sometimes the debris that you get on there can't be seen, but it's there nonetheless and can keep it from sealing. Jars are usually the cleanest. But when it starts gooping on the bottom, there's nothing you can do about that. Ouch. Okay. So, we're ready to lid these up. And finger tighten. Yes, ma'am. You want cake? Okay. Oh my gosh, this jar is so freaking hot, too. There we go. Jeez. I did not think that one was going on there at all. Usually you can just dose them on there like that and you're good to go, but... Now tighten. So this actually made 10 half pints, but that's probably because I had the extra lemon juice. So that is about that much in there. The bowl is a little wider. Yeah, it's about the same amount. So I'm going to hot water bath these for 10 minutes and we'll be back when that's done. Okay, so there is a difference in color once something has been water processed. Once the lemon curd is in water processed, there is a change in color. It's very slight. And I'll show you the difference right here. So this one has not been processed right here. This one has not been water bathed. And this one has. So there is a slight difference in color. It does darken just a little bit. So, but that is minuscule. It's more like a really dark. Let's see. That's not a true to color. Hang on just 1 second. Let me adjust my. Hang on, sweet girl. Okay, that's more of a true color. It's this one is a very, very, very light pale yellow, and this one is a little darker, but still very gorgeous color. And this one right here is just going to go in the refrigerator to be used on toast. One last thing, cleanup was a breeze. I got all of that cleaned up in the 10 minutes it took for the first batch to process in the water bath canning. So that was easy peasy and lemon squeezy. Just okay, so that's all I wanted to share. Thank you for joining me. Thank you for subscribing to my channel. Thank you for listening to me, and thank you for trying my recipes, and let me know what you think about them. Yahuah bless you and keep you and give you shalom. Until next time, God bless.